Operational report. Repairs complete. Detections. 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 Contact report. Kill credit. Contact report. Kill credit. Crash. Supplies moved. Repairs complete. Expansion Fukuoka is maximized, or airfield wise. Upgrades. One another slowpoke arrives at Vancouver. Quiet on the southeast coast of China. No aircraft in transit. No enemy activity. The lead elements of the African division have arrived, but I'm not going to load them just yet. The trailing elements are 2 days out. I'm going to let them come together before I load them. Reason is, I want to reform the division. There's a couple here. There's a mountain gun here. I guess it could use an upgrade, and we might get some 6-pounder anti-tank weapons as well. I don't want to be monkeying around with upgrading one third at a time, or each element at a time. So you have to have them all together in order to upgrade, in order to recombine and then upgrade. And I think I get the impression that when units are moved from one unit by ship from one unit to another, they load and unload from ships, I get the impression that they tend to upgrade more likely upgrade at that point. Sometimes they've been sitting there for months without an upgrade at a port, but the second you put them on a ship and put them on and unload them or fly them somewhere else, they seem to upgrade. So that's why I'm waiting for it. I'll wait for it, and they'll recombine, and then I'll put them together. I thought I was saving points to buy these. I realized that, oh yeah, I had to bring them on. I had to bring them by ship in the first place, so they are obviously not restricted. What an idiot I am. The transports are one hex away from Nagasaki, so we split them up, everyone sailing independently to return to drop in and unload. That's another, 700,000? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh yeah, 750,000 in supplies being dropped. The rest of the assault group, infantry, has arrived. Now we're at 17,000. We're going to attack again. We're going to use the infantry in deliberate, and my two guys who are leaving in 3 days, shock them! Burn them up! The ships, the battleships, a couple of them got damaged again. They're so brittle. Anyway, they're sitting here. They're pumping a little bit. They're going to take another... Well, the battleship's supposed to take 2 days. Well, we will repair what we can. That's about all I can do. And if it takes more, it takes more. But I think we're going to need a couple of days to clean out the rest of this nest of vipers. So 18,000, I think we can carry the day with 18,000. I am moving one headquarters from, where are we? Headquarters here. We had a Australian headquarters planning for Yokohama. None of the combat elements are planned or have a planning destination of Yokohama, so it probably means nothing. I'm pretty sure it means nothing. There's no combat benefit from this. Oh well, I tried. Anyway, I'm going to move up to Kofu, and then from Kofu, if we can capture this hex site into Tokyo, we're going to move from Kofu across to steal this hex site as well. The elements are moving down the 1300 or so assault value. We're moving down behind. Okay, it's a first day of March. Only 16 miles made, that's understandable. We were sweeping from, we were sweeping with P-38 hotels. We're going to do it again with P-38 hotels, but a different group of P-38 hotel fighters. So three more are going to sweep on Tokyo. The trailing elements of the Africans are, yeah, just passing Jehol. The base force heading towards Liuqiao, nothing available at Changsha. Nothing on Langson. Okay, they've arrived. The commando brigade has arrived at Binhua, heading over to Langson. These guys are trying to break trail, heading off to Binhua. These guys are moving through, heading for Phnom Penh, breaking trail down to Binhua. No other units coming through. This one, the 15th Indian Brigade, is pretty far away. Going to take a little while to get down here. We're quiet on Singapore. Moulmien, lots of units moving in lots of different directions. 96th Alpha Element is here. Okay, we're going to combat. This is the final garrison unit for Moulmien. No movement on Rangoon. Look at all these guys trying to get out of here. Okay, well, they're on the train. All they can do is wait until they arrive at the... Oh, here's one already. Route Army's already... Oh, it's, this one's heading for Bombay. Boy, that was quick. And one, we need someone to relieve the Calcutta garrison so that we can move this one forward. The aircraft transferred to Calcutta are ready. Some of them are. Okay, this one, the Hurricanes, strap on the tanks. As we can only go as far as Rangoon, I believe. I believe that's... Yeah, there we go, Rangoon. Okay, so we're doing leapfrog across Asia. No other reinforcements in Chittagong. The destroyers are just about to enter Colombo. Quiet on Bombay. Convoys in and out, Karachi. Here's a tanker group heading back to Abadan when it's finished unloading. No tankers at Abadan loading. Aden, well, two transport groups, one fast one for 30,000 and another small one for 60,000. So that's another, 100,000 taken out of here. And, oh, look at that, we've already got it down to 130,000, so this one, well, after we take this one, it'll be down to 30,000 again, 40,000. Can you believe that? I just sucked out 2 million supply out of Aden. I didn't think I would have to go back to South Africa to get more supplies, but it looks like I'm going to send the big ships back to South Africa. We did take a look at the ground reinforcements, and there's going to be another convoy every month or so at Aden. The next convoy coming is under half a million supplies, and then next month, so total of a million supplies over the next couple of months, and then back to Aden another 120, only 120. So, you know, once I drain this sucker, and I'm going to drain the 400,000, I really do have to send the big ships back to South Africa to load supplies, the big long-range ships. I never thought it would happen. No other reinforcements at Aden. Oops, we have no enemy detected around Truk. We sank the last one. Okay, back to Panay to rearm and refuel. No ships in Panama, no activity in Pearl Harbor. No reinforcements on the west coast. But I did want to buy out a couple more squadrons of these And last turn I didn't because I thought I might have to spend them on ground units in Asia. The only ground unit, well, that might be purchased from Asia is the Indian Brigade here. So I'm going to do it now. 300 is it'll cost, what, 75, 80 points? 80, 81 points? Okay. Done. Now that we've purchased it, the one in Calcutta is free because it's Indian Corps, so it's unrestricted. Now, we purchased the mortar battalion last turn, getting it ready to go. I can purchase a couple of these. Geez, this one's leaving June 45. So it doesn't really matter which one I grab. Six of one, half dozen the other. I'm going to grab the first two then. Hell, I could grab all of them. It's not that they're not that many points. They're just 9 points each. But somebody's got to train the new boys. So I'll buy them, and we'll move them when we have an opportunity. And the last one. So I've got two AKVs here. I'll form them. Let's grab which one? 1415? Sure. I'm going to drop them off at Hajima instead. Why? Because Hajima needs the supplies. I think we've got a black hole bug here. So I'm going to try to get as many supplies into the place as possible. A number of transports have returned. These are troop transports. A lot of them are damaged, waiting to go. I'm going to wait a turn for there. It's only going to take a turn to repair them. Well, most of them. Doomer, idiot, is in shipyards. Going to take an extra turn to repair her, if we bother at all. And then I'll use them. I'll wait for them all to accumulate, and then one. We'll load the mortar unit and head out. So I'm going to delay one turn. Los Angeles, no reinforcements either, but we have a whole bunch of specialty ships returned and another group of tankers in, but we also have a group of tankers going out. These are the troop transports loaded with supplies heading for Iwo. Oops. Turn off the refuel. Heading for Iwo Jima. One tanker group loaded, heading out. Another tanker group loading, heading out. Oh, why these AOs? Hold on, I should move the AOs in. I don't think it makes much of a difference. We use the load tender command so that they can load some fuel already. And then put them back in the tanker convoy. These are the undamaged ones. So if we're lucky, maybe we'll be able to fill it and be gone by the end of the turn. We also have a group of support, special, very fast support ships, submarine tenders and destroyer tenders, 1718s. They've already loaded. I'm going to order them to Hajima again. Hajima just seems to be burning up supplies at a phenomenal rate. Iwo Jima, we continue to gather ships. Not very many now. Tankers are unloading. Well, we're now into the spoilage area, but I'm still going to unload it because we'll probably use it up very quickly. We have a limit of 129,000, and we are at the 141,000 mark with another 9,000 coming in. So Yeah, we're overloading it. We're overloading it. But we'll send them back for more. When these transports or when the carriers come back with their escorts, they drink it up very, very quickly. But we don't have enough ships to send another group. There's what? 12 tankers in port, a few trans, one AK, and that's about it. So that's not enough to send to Japan. We're waiting for more to gather. An E boat has wandered into Fusan and met up with the PT boats, but the visibility is long, and we've seen them at 17,000 yards, and they both managed to evade. Fighter sweep over Tokyo. The enemy puts up 9 fighters. We drop in with 22. We shoot down five, six, no, five, but we also lose a lightning. Not a good day. Bombing practice, Ikishima. Air raid, Osaka. 5 lilies bomb, 3 are shot down. Air raid, Osaka. 3 Nels, 2 are shot down. Fighter sweep, Tokyo. Nothing. I think I missed a bombing raid there too. There was an attack on an RAF base force. I think it was at Yokohama. Bombardment, Yokohama. Minor Japanese casualties, no Allied casualties. Bombardment, Maebashi. Minor Japanese casualties. Shock attack, Yokohama. Well, two units don't constitute a shock attack, of course. Reduce fortifications to 4, but we still outnumber 9-1. Okay, 7,000 casualties. That's a heavy casualty load, and we destroyed a great number of the enemy. That's important. Guns destroyed, vehicles destroyed. But the enemy gets a few of ours as well. The units that can retreat will retreat, but the naval fortresses, a Tokyo Bay fortress and Yokosuka, cannot move. They're static. So we see all these. Ah, there we go. Wiped out. Wiped out. Two of them. They're both wiped out due to attrition. Lots of expansions. I wonder if we own the hex free and clear now.